I'm going to take a little, I don't want to say the word break because Sean will break. I want to take a little detour from our nostalgia, and I'm coming back to it, so don't go away. But it's time to do another little rant on fact-checking. This time it's Dave Ramsey and his reverse mortgage claims. Now this time I have help. Last time I didn't. This time Harlan Akola published this article on August 30th, 2021. And so we get some help from that person. And I'm going to do some reading now. So if I sound like I'm in monotone, don't tell me, I always do. The federally insured reverse mortgage product known as a home equity conversion mortgage has been around for over 30 years. During many of those years, the most vocal critic of the product has been author and radio personality Dave Ramsey. Why is this important to this was a NASDAQ article, so readers, because Ramsey is one of the most listened to financial gurus on the planet, coming right after me. Many Ramsey listeners who would be ideal candidates for the product are aggressively steered away, as he repeatedly calls it a scam. This scam has been enjoyed by homeowners who overwhelmingly rate they are satisfied or highly satisfied with the results, and you can count me in on that. Nevertheless, many older Americans are being hurt by Dave Ramsey's continued misinformation and lack of knowledge about the product. For example, Ramsey and his writers at Ramsey Solutions have repeatedly scared older homeowners with the claim, "You'll likely owe more than your home is worth." Ramsey Solutions also claims that not only are reverse mortgages a black hole of fees, but your older loved ones could also end up owing more on their home than it's worth, or worse, losing their home altogether. Both of those statements conflict with federal law regarding reverse mortgages. My helper here has written, and very true. One of the first lessons a reverse mortgage prospect learns from the reverse mortgage specialist is that FHA guarantees this cannot happen. Let me repeat, guarantees this cannot happen. In fact, every reverse mortgage applicant is required to complete a HUD-approved counseling session where the non-recourse clause is covered. Let's be clear, every reverse mortgage in America is non-recourse, meaning neither the borrower nor the estate will owe more than the home is worth at the time the mortgage is due. Now, purchase money loans in California are also non-recourse, so don't forget that. Refinances are not, seconds, things like that are not. But in any case, one more thing is that if we do, well, you know, I don't want to get into too much, get ahead of myself. But if we have another period like 08 where this could happen and your house is worth less, of course you want to hold on to it because everybody knows values are coming back. But let's say you pass away at that time and your children, they definitely want to have that house because they know prices are coming back. They have a whole year to cure this and they never pay the loan amount if the loan amount is higher than the value of the home. In fact, they pay 95% at that time of the value and have a whole year to figure out how to do it, whether it's to sell it, purchase, refinance, whatever. A lot of times the children of age are 62 and older, and no problem with that. So let's understand leverage, because I take it that that our hero here, Dave Ramsey, understands leverage completely, but he doesn't want to tell you what he knows, because I think he's made a name for himself being contrary to any kind of debt, and that's what makes him famous. It's kind of like saying, I was told once that Rush Limbaugh was a liberal, but he pretended to be a conservative because that was the niche that made him money. Well, I don't know that that's true, but I do know that it's true with Dave Ramsey, because he's not that stupid. Where is he? So the fundamental conflict between the reverse mortgage and Dave Ramsey in his overzealous hatred of debt. Okay, I get it. But for the most part, you may agree, many people in this country are overleveraged with credit card debt, and we know that it is dangerous. Mr. Ramsey recently claimed that on social media, there's no such thing as good debt. Well, guess what? There is such a thing as good leverage, and that may be hiding as debt. I believe the CFO, Chief Financial Officer, of every Fortune 500 company would respectfully, maybe with respect, maybe not, but they would certainly disagree with Dave Ramsey, because their understanding of leverage is a lot different. Well, I think that Dave Ramsey understands it. He just doesn't want to tell you, because he makes his money by telling you different things. And sorry, Dave, but you know, you've been invited to this show, never did it. So many people I've talked to said they have invited Dave Ramsey to argue this point or discuss it, and he won't do it because he's afraid he'll be shown as wrong. And that is not good. So it's no different in the mortgage world. Ironically, Dave Ramsey is a paid lead provider for Churchill Mortgage. Nothing wrong with Churchill Mortgage that I know of, but he gets paid for giving them leads. And guess what? Those leads are sold debt. So a well-respected mortgage firm, it said, however, 100% of their business uses debt to achieve the dream of home ownership. Apparently, there is good debt that can be properly used. And in my book, the person that wrote this, Home Equity and Reverse Mortgages, The Cinderella of the Baby Boomer Retirement, is entitled Sex, Drugs, and Reverse Mortgages. Most of us would, I'll get back to who this person is in case you want to look that up. And I'll look that up and try to put it on next week's show. Most of us would completely agree that many things can be good and or evil depending on how they're used. So consider a retired homeowner with a home valued at $450,000 with no existing mortgage balance. She decides to use some of her equity to pay off $50,000 in medical debt and high interest rate consumer debt caused by unforeseen circumstances. Keep in mind the resulting HECM, reverse, balance is financed at 2% to 3%, and that's still the way it is, and has no required monthly principal and interest payment obligation. It also does not disrupt the homeowner's traditional retirement plan, in our view, that and mine too, that is a proper use of home equity in retirement. Sadly, some Ramsey followers are so afraid of using the most powerful lever they own, home equity, that they may never be able to eliminate debt and withstand financial shocks on a fixed income. And boy, don't we talk about that a lot. So whether retirees will never discover the value of the reverse mortgage, acquisition indebtedness to increase their tax liability, avoid sequence of return risk, which we've talked about, especially with Phil Walker as our guest, or creating better Roth conversions if they listen to Ramsey's rants, when home equity is used as a substitute for withdrawal from retirement accounts, several financial planning researchers have proved that though equity may decrease over the net worth increases, which increase greater wealth while alive and is instrumental in leaving a larger legacy for the next generation. Also, just as an aside, we've talked about this and done so on Ron Siegel's show, who does purport that if you leave all the money in your home equity, it's like burying that money in a coffee can in the backyard. But, you know, for the last 61 years, according to Ron, and, you know, we fact-checked this, the overall average increase in home values or appreciation has been 5.9%. When you get a reverse mortgage, you're starting out with, you know, about half of the amount of the home. So if the home is increasing, and I'm talking about all of California here, if the home is increasing at 5.9 and half of your equity or the value is increasing at 2 to 3%, well, I think you can do the math. Let's fact check some of Dave Ramsey's most harmful claims about reverse mortgages. And claim number one, over 100,000 reverse mortgages have failed, resulting in foreclosures and evictions. This is absolutely false. In this statement, Dave is parroting, probably want a cracker, information from a national publication. Yes, the aftermath of the housing meltdown 12 years ago were about 100,000 foreclosures that involved homeowners that had reverse mortgages. However, those foreclosures were not failures of the reverse mortgage. No, most were foreclosed, the foreclosures between 2008 and 2012, and most all of them were what we call in the business beneficial or neutral foreclosures from the borrower's perspective. By beneficial, I mean that more money was borrowed than the home sale could satisfy after the death of the last borrower. And again, remember how that really can't happen except in some short-term periods like this. This occurred in the years following the housing crash. The heirs naturally walked away from the underwater property. Boy, if that were a BMW, I bet they wouldn't walk away because it's worth less than what you owe the second you drive it off the lot. But the lender or HUD foreclosed on the vacant property to sell the home at a loss. So nobody lost anything. The borrowers had passed away. By neutral, I mean that foreclosure was a result of property tax default and not because the borrower had a reverse mortgage. As you know, if you don't pay your property taxes, you will lose your home, whether you have a traditional mortgage as a reverse mortgage or even no mortgage at all. So think about it, a reverse mortgage eliminates the required mortgage payment and gives the borrower cash. This does not make them more likely to default on their tax bill. Claim two, this is from Dave Know-It-All Ramsey. If you die before you've sold your home, those you leave behind are stuck with two options. They can either pay off the full reverse mortgage, which we already know is not true if it's worth more than the home, and all the interest that piled up over the years, or surrender the house to bank. The bank, that too, is absolutely false. This statement is designed to create fear that the reverse mortgage will stick the heirs with a bill or cause them to lose the home. Fear does sell, let's face it. And Dave Ramsey is using fear to sell his brand, even though he's making good money by selling leads to another mortgage company. The U.S. Department of Housing and Development, or HUD as we call it, which is the regulator of the HECM, and the Federal Housing Administration, FHA, the insurer of the HECM product, allows heirs 6 months to sell the home and up to two 90-day extensions. So that's 12 months or a year to sell the home or refinance it. This sale is a form of inheritance for the heirs, and Dave ignores this common and favorable option. So any and all of the available, or all of the, well, I'll say available equity after the sale or selling cost belongs only to the heirs, okay? Just like any other loan. And what about other things that the borrower may or may, if they were poor, maybe they don't have a whole lot, but they still had their house right till the end. If they have more money or money in the bank, the heirs are going to get all the money in the bank and all the investments because they didn't have to take those investments and make them smaller by paying things that the reverse mortgage could cover. So keep in mind, most heirs are consent to sell the home and receive the remaining equity. When no equity remains, the heirs often fail to recognize that without the reverse mortgage paying for the costs of aging, the heirs would have been left with the bills the HECM paid. And that's, we've got medical, we've got so much else also. And I've checked with CPAs and most agree that the heirs, when they pay it off, will have paid off interest, and all that interest then will go to credit the new owners, and that would be one huge good thing when it comes to, you know, paying the taxes on taking over the property. So even if it's underwater, they have the potential for a tax deduction, but that is a discussion for a separate column. Yeah, but you know, I got into it a little bit. Look at, anyway, claim number three, you won't qualify for reverse mortgages. Your home is worth more than a certain amount. That is false. Absolutely false, and only reflects something that someone who knows nothing, I mean nothing, about reverse mortgages would say, unless he's going way out of his way to give you some kind of fear, and that Dave is the Messiah guy that will save you. No, Dave, you are the troublemaker that keeps people poor. This is nonsensical and underscores how little Dave knows about the Heckam product. No lender has ever disqualified a borrower for a Heckam because their appraisal came in higher than expected. Yes, HUD does establish Heckam limits each year. However, when a home appraisal exceeds the HEMA limit, this doesn't hurt the borrower at all, and they still qualify. Now, of course, we have the jumbo, so that's one more choice. For example, the Heckam product in 2021 provides insurance to the lender of the home's value up to $822,375. This limit simply restricts the home value to $822,375 when calculating the proceeds. It's just part of the equation. For example, a borrower with a $1 million home who qualifies for proceeds of 60%, yeah, you can do that now, because the rates are so low,
so set them up,
and
Joe,
if you're older, anyway, will not qualify for $600,000 in principal. Rather, they will qualify for 60% of the $822,000 or $493,000. In essence, a borrower with a home value that exceeds $822,375 has simply maximized their initial principal limit for this product.
Of a brief episode.
And again, we have the jumbos that go way up above that. While we won't have time to cover
make
each false claim in detail, here are some notable past statements from Dave Ramsey and Ramsey Non-Solutions that unfairly disparage the Heckam product. And you will pay a hefty mortgage insurance premium that protects the lender, not you, against losses. False. Absolutely false. And I will get into that after we get back onto this subject.
That's how it goes. And Joe, I know you're getting anxious to close. And thanks for the cheer.
So let's get on.
I hope you didn't mind
last week with concerning Dave Ramsey. And again,
but
well,
this time
it's just he either does not understand or has never studied it, and I have a feeling that he's smart enough to understand, but that he needs to build a reputation, and that's one way of doing it. So be it. Anyway, let me get to one of his, and again, I have help from this other fella I talked about last week who wrote this story that is in NASDAQ magazine or publication. And according to Dave Ramsey, you'll pay a hefty mortgage insurance premium that protects the lender, not you, against any losses. That is completely false. The primary purpose of the mortgage insurance premium, MIP, is to pay for losses resulting from the non-recourse nature of the product. This is primarily for the benefit of the borrower and their heirs, as well as the investor who owns the paper. That lender would likely not have made the same loan for the benefit of the borrower without the guarantee from the FHA insurance. Now, two quick points on that is, is it good for the borrower? Of course, the simple answer is that they couldn't get this unless that existed. There are other non-recourse loans in California, which we've talked about before, but let's look at some other things on top of that. You get a payment for the rest of your life, regardless of what happens to the value of the property, which probably won't go down. But if there's a period where it will, you're still covered. You've still got your income should you decide to take income from it. Most people don't. Most people actually leave it in the line of credit, allows it to grow, and take it as and when needed. And some of that is for health care, for maybe giving contributions to your grandchildren, for school, memories now instead of later, living memories, we like to think of them as, or investments too. Remember, you can take money out and buy an investment. You can buy another property. You can collect the rent from that other property. And depending on where it is and what's owed on it, you don't have a payment on either one. Now, what's that going to do to your overall legacy and your overall value? Yes, the balance of the loan on your current home is going to go up. The equity is going to go up at a faster rate than most likely. And what's going to happen to your overall level of, your financial future? It's going to go up. You're going to have more money in 10, 20 years than if you had not done that. So as far as it being expensive, there is an amount there. People are familiar with mortgage insurance, but just ask yourself, hey, how much have you paid into your auto insurance over your lifetime minus the amount they paid you back for whatever? Was that expensive? Well, it's this is nothing compared to that. So here's another falsism from Mr. Ramsey. You are also required to take a loan for the maximum amount you qualify for. And that is not true. It's false. Not only is it false, but the federal government prohibits borrowers from taking all the proceeds up front unless needed to pay a large mortgage balance at closing. But even that is limited. This has been HUD's policy since 2013, called initial disbursement limits. On the other hand, I don't think that Dave Ramsey is making any correlation with what he means by amount you qualify for, because just to begin with, the amount, the 100% of what you qualify for in this environment of low interest rates is a bit over 50%. So believe me, you're nowhere near what he's making reference to. The interest rates that they've calculated are horrendously bad. No, they're not. You have to know that he's never looked at it. Most of the years, for most of not since the beginning in 1988, HECM or reverse rates have been at or below conforming rates. So that is an out and out falsehood. I really don't want to call it a lie because that's, but you know what it is. Servicing fees. These are another monthly expense coming your way with a reverse mortgage. No, they're not. That's another falsehood. And while HUD permits the use of servicing fees, we haven't been seen. They have not been seen in a HECM or reverse mortgage for well over 10 years. And even then, I'm not sure how much of it was around. The federally insured reverse mortgage product is continuously improving with new customer protections and long-term advantages for those who wish to age in place. And if you just heard our little talk with Dr. Arash, you know how important being in place can be. Do your own research and don't let radio personalities with little knowledge about a product impact your retirement cash flow decisions. You need to make up your own mind and you need to know what it is that is being talked about. And unfortunately, I think Dave Ramsey knows this, and I don't want to accuse him of whatever, but I will accuse him of giving the wrong information. How and why he gets there, Well, you can take your choice. I've taken mine. And I think that he is not at all doing a good service to the aging population of this country, or any country for that matter. And so many people can be helped out. And even if you don't need help, so many people can expand their legacy and their just their lives, their quality of life. But so be it. We're going to let that go for now. And you know, do your own research. Call me if nothing else. So let's get back to some of our even older.